Friends, welcome back to my channel. Most of the time when I am sharing the videos for repairing SMPS, switch mode power supply, I always say V in AC. Here I am taking 232 volt, 31 volt, multiply it by 1.414, so we will receive 325 volt DC at bulk capacitor. For example, I say we apply input voltage here. After passing through bridge rectifier, I will take 325 volt DC at the capacitor. This voltage must be at this capacitor. V in, how much? 220, 230, 110, 115, multiply it by 1.414, so we will receive 325 volt at this capacitor. I receive many time a question, why you are multiplying with 1.414? So I decided to make video to reply all my friends. First of all, we have to consider what are these voltage. We have to see red lead, black lead are connected to line voltage, directly line voltage. So our multimeter is reading 232 volt and we are taking voltage at screen also. So this is positive peak and negative peak. So we have positive peak, it is one cycle from here to here, it is positive peak and negative peak. Our this multimeter is reading from this center line, zero line, to this point, it is 0.707 of the total value, that is called RMS value. RMS value is actual effective value equal to DC voltage. So this peak, total peak, the upper voltage are useless, we can say. This level of the voltage is useful as working as DC voltage. So our multimeter shows RMS value. But when we discuss any circuit, when we calculate any circuit, we take from this point to top. So convert RMS value to peak value, VRMS to V peak, we use VRMS square root 2. Square root 2 is VRMS multiply 1.414. So square root 2 is 1.414. Square root 2 is 1.414. So if we have 232 volt square root 2, 328 volt. Now I want to check, this is RMS value, 232 volt, these are RMS voltage, so we can say it is the peak, it is 324 volts. Our calculation says 328 because I make attenuation. I attenuated the signal, so attenuated signal sometime needs calibration. So it is 328 volt. So when we calculate the output of the bridge rectifier, in that case, we select from zero line to maximum peak voltage. So to take peak voltage, these voltage, we multiply it with 1.414. That is actually VRMS to VRMS square root 2. And if we want to take peak to peak, then we have to multiply it AC voltage, RMS voltage, multiplied by 2 square root 2. So that means it should be 656 volt peak to peak. I will put Meyer, peak to peak 640 volts. The calculation says 656 as it is, as I discussed, it is attenuated signal, attenuated voltage. So that means that is reason it is reading 640. So actually it is 656 volt. So this level, now it is measuring from this point to this point. And 320 from this line to maximum line. Negative peak is minus 320 volt and positive peak is 320 volt. So 320, 320, 640 volt. And when we select bridge rectifier removes these negative peaks and shifts them in positive side. So our signal comes here in this blank period, this pulse is shifted in this point. The output of bridge rectifier comes here. So these negative pulses are clipped off and transferred in this portion. It is filled here. So that is reason the output frequency of bridge rectifier always 2f, double to the input frequency. If it is here 50 hertz, the output of bridge rectifier and full wave rectifier will 100 hertz, 2f. What is the frequency here? It will double the frequency. So that is the reason most of the time in the circuits, full wave and bridge rectifier is used. I hope so, friends, this video is informative for you. If it is informative, press the bell icon button. And if you have not subscribed my channel, subscribe it. And if you want to watch my future videos, press bell icon button. And if you have any question, any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. Thankful for watching my videos. Stay blessed. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.